Quit pushing me, dog. Yeah. Alright, well, hey yo, it's pizza. My dog is already bothering me, pushing me around. Rascal is mean. He's so mean. Well, let's see. So the first diamond I shot on this map, man, that wind on that pole is no joke, huh? There we go. Yeah. Alright. The first diamond I shot on this map was a red deer, but I shot it with the 300. So. But I just got in my last video, if you want, at about up to you. I would start at the 29 minute mark, but you could start at the 30 minute mark too. You can see me get this diamond access, and I was pretty stoked, and I was thinking about taking it to my lodge, and I remembered. They have a fancy lodge here that you can put your trophies in, but I don't know where it is. So, and I'm also curious because, like, I want to be able, one, to take it back. I don't know if that's a thing, and because I would rather have it in my one of my other lodges. So. No. Okay. What do we think? What are we, the, maybe it's right here. Right? Central in the map. Hey, Martin. I can't. Alright, let's go see. So.
Not all tracks lead to animals, so I always apply the sniff test. If the droppings are fresh, your game is close by, but if you find all the droppings, that animal is long gone, and you should look for the more recent trail.
Whoa. This happened before. Is it this outpost? Does it? I don't know. Sometimes fast traveling to maybe, I think, I mean, it looks familiar because I remember having trouble with this hill. Yeah, I don't know. It doesn't take me to the outpost. It drops me off literally from in the air onto the ground. I don't think this is it either. Nope. This is it. Alright, right? And this is a special trophy lodge. Yeah, it's gotta be. It's way bigger. I mean, I've barely even been on this map. If you don't know, or since I'm 100% sure you haven't seen any of my other videos, I don't, whatever, this map used to lag out after about 30 or 45 minutes of gameplay. So I haven't really played here much. But I got a diamond axis. Why do I keep doing that? And, oh. Just here, huh? I'm nervous. Oh, just antlers, huh? It doesn't say I can pick it up, does it? I better be able to place this deer. I mean, that doesn't even look like the rack. Wait, it's way smaller. It doesn't look at all like what I got, so I'm really hoping that when I get back to my trophy lodge, I can place this animal. I have to, right? I paid for it. It's just part of the game. Yeah. I'm not saying it better be part of the game, but I kind of feel like it better be part of the game. Anyway, I shot the thing at like 11 yards. I just was talking about how you gotta sometimes chase down a random call, which I heard. What is going on with the sound? And I was creeping through the woods. This is the reenactment. It's really good, isn't it? And bam. The dog pushed me, and I scolded the dog. I was like, bad rascal, you're bad, bad, bad dog, bad demon, murderer, look at him run. Who knows? Who knows? Who knows? But, and then I just came up above a ridge, and I uttered those famous words that people have uttered probably throughout time, for sure, and just a ridiculous amount of times, you gotta imagine. Holy crap. Yeah, that's what I say when I crest a hill and there's an animal like right in front of me. And then I was like, I gotta get it. And then I shot it in the heart. Oh yeah, did you hear the brag? And that, the braggadocio? Oh yeah. Got that guy. But you say, is it that hard to shoot an animal in the heart at 11 yards? Nah. I'd say you have a valid point. I'd say you have a pretty valid point. Here's the shooting range in Parque, if you don't know. I like to shoot from here. This is gives you a look at all the targets, and you can range out how you want. Infinite ammo. As well as the shooting range in Hirschfelden, also, if you didn't know. And the one in Hirschfelden really is for long range, like, rifles. Like, I would test my pistols and shotguns out here, too. Not would, did. So. Anyway, so, you know, this one's at about 40, 28, you know, let's say 30-ish. 20-ish. I think the duck is the closest, right? About 25 yards. 55. I would, you know, focus on your 55. That's for funsies. I mean, you can learn. You gotta aim real high. And the wind's gotta be good. But you can get this guy for sure. I just gotta say, putting those antlers on the wall, I feel, was super, anticlimactic. I mean, like, I was really excited. So, yeah. Not the denouement. And it's not even, it doesn't even look like what I shot at all. And it's way smaller. And the spread isn't right at all. It's just not the same. It's just some standard little thing it throws up here when it says you got it. I mean, I think this is super disappointing because I was really excited because, I mean, even if it was, all right, you know, just the antlers, all right, put the ones I shot up at least. So none of these are, it's going to look like everybody else's. Look at him. It's going to look just like everybody else's. So, I mean, I guess it's a brag because you're like, yeah, look, I built out the lodge. I got all the diamonds. I haven't seen this porch part. Yeah, like I said, I barely know this. Let's face it, this is great. Just like their lobsters, I mean, it's beautiful, but, you know. Oh, turlet. Do we have a sink in this one? No. No sinks in this video. In South America here. We just don't have them. Alright. What to do? Well, I want to gossip about the new map in Mississippi. Pretty excited. I'm from the south. Oh, yeah, I was going here. How did I get up there? Oh, I had to put that goofy thing in there. Alright, let's go. So I'm calling this Pizza and a Bottle of Wine because I'm drinking some wine that is left over from yesterday that didn't get drunk. And I'm about a glass and a half in. So, we'll see how this beach goes. It is a Chardonnay. And I'm not a big fan of white wine, honestly. But red wine gives me a headache. I like it way better. Except for Malbecs. Delicious, by the way. And I'm going to use my wine lingo here. It's very grapey, which is what I enjoy. My palate. So Malbecs. I believe they're from Argentina. And they're super tasty. So morning first, I guess. What time is it? 12. No. I got a long this one. Oh. Alright, we're gonna do it. I'm gonna put away. We're gonna remember that the place is inside on these. This is gonna be kind of a pain in the butt. I just want to get it done. I really hope there's some animals. Should I take two? No, because then I can't. Well, no, I could put one back. Well, how much have I made? 240. I need 160 for tripods and quattro. And a little more for like two more tents. Whatever, I get that. Because, oh, it's too heavy. Am I? Oh, I need to lose. Like, alright, we'll just drop. We'll go down to the bare minimum. Ugh. I guess I can switch to the. I'm going zone hunting. I'm going to drop a tent down there. Up there, way the hell, wherever it is. And, yeah. Going to see if there's any animals. Yep. I mean, the last time I followed an Axis deer call, I got a diamond. My bow this time. How far away is this thing? It's gotta be ridiculous. Yeah, it is a mile. So, we just get a diamond. We're probably not getting another one. Let's just get out of here. In fact, I'm gonna stay focused. At least while I can. So yeah, my Chardonnay, my fancy wine. Not my favorite kind of wine. Now I will tell you, I have had some fancy wine in my life. And I know that it's called fancy wine. That's how fancy I am. But no, I was at the Williamsburg Winery and they had, ooh, I see them, but they saw me, so, anyway, and for the first time in a long time, I saw, I saw it for sale, well, not a different brand. But it's called Butter Chardonnay. Oh man. And what I had was like $100 a glass. Stop behind the tree. That's it. Well, I hope you guys like spotting animals in the wild, because that's about all we're going to do here. I can't believe these females haven't spotted me yet. Oh, there he is. I went like two more, or one, no, definitely two more. Oh man, I wish I had that Hyperion off. Alright. Well, fancy music. Oh, fancy wine. Yeah, it was about $100 a bottle, and, or, no. It's $100 a glass. And, man, woo, it was delicious. Put to you this way, the first one was free. And we had more than one that day. Alright. Well, you know, I don't mind that. We made a little cash. The last lake I went and checked out, though. I mean, man. Oh. Alright, two. I know there was definitely one nice set of antlers in there, for sure. Three, maybe? No, that's the two. We walk back. I mean, you expect the two to come back in pretty quick. And the three and the four to linger. He's dark, though, isn't he? I'm going to shoot him. Oh, no. Not with that gun, though. Well, what is this? Well, did we shoot the... He's definitely darker, right? I mean, I got a melanistic the other day, so I mean, I know it's not that. It definitely looks not like that at all. But I guess maybe there's like a darker variety. I'm curious about. So. We'll skip to three and see what this thing is. It definitely looks different, right? Oh, Oh, yeah. He's something different. What's up, Bella? Dark. Heart shot. I probably say it in every video where I use the Solokin. I love that gun. Great accuracy, good bullet. Generally, your animals are going to have a medium bleed rate, so, you know, I'd say shots within 200 yards are just a beast. Another rifle shot. Where am I? Yeah. I can get away with it. Should you walk and call? It's up to you. There's merits for it. It's because you don't. You want to get them to stop. Is what I'm trying to do usually. They come in, it's a bonus. Yep. It's right there. Isn't it? There's another one. You're trying to kill me. Well, let me see your cousin. I'll get revenge. There's another one. Wow. You know what? Let's get out of here. Let's go. What we're doing today, although good to remember. This zone is packed. Where am I? Submarine, right? Although it looks like a fish fin. I'm going with submarine. I'm gonna run down here and see how many are on this zone. That's a lot of tracks, right? And no lag, so. So we're ready for that. No. Where are the little things? No. Well, come on. I don't understand it all. I'm out of here. I don't have time for this. We got a long way to go and a short time to get there. Pizza had some wine. He's singing. So yeah, I got my screw top Chardonnay. It was the wine no one wanted to drink. And not a butter Chardonnay. But we don't want headaches. That's not gonna work. I'm not doing that. Yeah. I'm trying to say it's not very good. But does alcohol have to be good? I guess it depends on the purpose. The drive. And today, it doesn't really matter. My children are grown and doing their thing today. People are off to their destinations. I got nothing to do but play Call of the Wild and drink a bottle of wine and get the munchies and eat cold turkey with cranberries, and I had some sweet potatoes. That was my we'll call it dinner. And whatever else is left, we'll see what the scavengers have left. Oh, well, good time to do new map gossip. That's what I wrote in the description. So Mississippi, I'm really excited about that. Why, pizza, would you be excited about that? Well, I lived there for 3.5 years. So, Biloxi, Mississippi. So, I'm excited. And I've grown up in the South. I've lived all over it. Well, Mississippi, Alabama, Virginia, Maryland. And depending on who you talk to, some people don't consider Maryland Southern, and including people from Maryland. I did. But, so yeah, you know, I thought about it, playing all these maps, and I keep thinking, you really got to get a southeastern map to hunt in, because there's just so much wildlife there, so much game. I'm also curious if they're going to add more animals at some point. Because I believe right now, they don't have any ducks. Which just doesn't make sense at all. Because the Southeast, and I'm going to throw it all in there, I'm sure Mississippi has a lot of different, and a lot as in volume of ducks, because that's just pretty much everywhere here. And any at Maryland to Alabama to Mississippi, all the duck hunting is just like, that's a big part of hunting in those states, with, like I said, a variety of different types. So I assume from some of the YouTubers that I watch that the conjecture is that they'll be introduced after they fix the ducks. So, I mean, if you think about it though, all right. You release the map, and then later on you release some ducks to sort of be like, hey, check out, you know. You were playing this for 3 months, and you got bored, and you went back to wherever your favorite map is. Well, guess what? Now we got the ducks here, and we fixed all the ducks, and now come in. So maybe have more than one variety. I'm going to start looking for a flat space to try to put this tent down. Where am I on the map? Sure. It'll be a heck of a lot closer than I was. Yeah, up here maybe, on this ridge. Oh, you gotta click on the tent to put it down. Yeah. See, I knew this weird little space would work. So, still really far from this other lake, but again, a heck of a lot closer than that. I'll leave it here. Why not? I could reset the time now, but I mean, it's only an hour now. It's only an hour in. Wait. Sorry guys, just resetting my stuff. Hopefully for reasons, as in there's stuff in here. I guess I'd leave a tent. You know what, I guess. Alright, so I'm intent on hunting this place. So I was going to drop down around 275 anyway. I was going to start walking. Probably walk to about 150. But we have a rest zone, folks, and I am curious. So we're creeping. Well, crawling. Crouching? Crouching. I'd rather crawl on my belly. It seems like it would consume less, you know, energy and effort. Axes, cool. This, man, I have found so many axes. Water, feed. I'm excited. I want to get some more mule deer, though. You said pizza. Do you have a diamond mule deer? I sure do. Well, why did you pause like that? That seems weird. Well, dramatic effect. Well, we're not stupid, pizza. We got that. Why? Well, because it's an albino. That's right. Pizza has a diamond albino mule deer. And I want more. Let's face it. I mean, let's really just I mean, obviously I need a diamond melanistic and a diamond piebald, right? Yeah, I mean, you can't leave the collection incomplete. All right, now the question is, do you have a big brother? Do I shit you anyway? Because that's probably exactly what I'm going to do. Because, where's my wind? Oh, my wind is great. We'll creep in a little bit. I'm not super patient. That's fine. I'm not patient. And, Now, the smart thing would be would not shoot this thing and make sure it's not the only one on the zone, because it might come be other deer that show up on the zone. Right? I mean, that makes sense, because sometimes it's when you're first starting on a map and you're looking, there's only one deer on the zone. It makes sense. But, or, you know. I mean, if it's one deer on the zone, it's gonna get knocked out anyway, right?
Yeah.
A little low. So, is there a zone on the map? Yep. Okay. Man, we just made a lot of noise, so let's save us some time. I'm excited because early times. You know what, though? Well, I got to go down here and look. I feel the justification coming on, you guys. I needed to get down here to look, and, you know, I was going to scare this deer anyway. Not alone, were you? Is that a female, though? Oh, no. I'd be nervous, too. But how nervous would I be? I'm not that nervous. I at least want to know who's talking to me. Who's brash character that just decided to say hello? Right? You want to know, right? Well, sure. Oh, you're drinking. Well, then, you know, again, the zone could be gone. See. I don't think it will be. You never know. Now, the smart thing to do, kiddos, since I had, you know what? Do the due diligence. Do the smart thing. That deer's not going anywhere. I should have crept up. I should have shot him with the bow. I should have left the zone as is and come back tomorrow. Or whatever. Change the time after I searched this shoreline. But, nope. I shot him. He's dead and the zone's still here. So maybe there was a female I didn't see. Maybe there's other males I didn't see. That's too far. Too far. There we go. On the edge of it, anyway. Yeah. Too far. There we go. Probably too close. Alright, let's go get my friend and let's see. How do we want to tackle this? Go left. Oh, see, the zone cuts off. Oh, well, that's easy. That's even easier. I wonder if it'll be a mix of zones. It might be. Might be. Yep. Oh, look at that. Nice. Gold medal. Not a bad, bad deer. Well, I guess we'll check them both out. We'll go right first because it's shorter. Well, it stopped running. And then we'll go left till we can't go anymore. And I have a feeling, you know, I really do, that it's going to be a mix of zones. What's a mix of zones? Well, probably, it could be that it might only be this one axis steer out here. Zone. And then maybe a mule deer at 9 or 9:30. Or some buffalo. Although, I don't think this is their part of the map. Especially this. I mean, since they're really supposed to be on that far right of the map. You guys. That's what we're doing after this. Alright, after I check that other lake. Alright, so. Focus. Pizza. The new map. Mississippi. I'm excited. I live there. Blah, blah, blah. Let's talk about species. We have raccoon, which I'm cool with. I just feel like, and I was saying it in one of my earlier videos, you know, the South is really good for a varmint hunting map. And one of my favorite games a long time ago literally is called Varmint Hunter. It was so much fun. It was on the PC. It was, like, ridiculous as far as, like, design. I mean, it was just so simple and silly, but, man, I loved it. I loved it. I loved it. I loved it. And that's a big part of, like, Southern hunting is there's a lot of varmints, you know. And we, well, you know, we eat them, you know, so you might think of squirrel hunting as like, that's kind of what the hicks do in the hills. Well, we're all like hicks in the hills in the South. And so a lot of like, I was kind of hoping for squirrel, cause can you imagine trying to pop those little guys? I mean, we're shooting ducks, which are a fairly small target. I don't know. I was kind of hoping some squirrels and some trees, maybe. But I could see how that would be a really difficult game mechanic to add into a map when you're trying to use basically the same system you're using on all your other maps. So you'd have to, like, change the game a little bit. But the other thing I was kind of wishing for was possum. And that's the official term for people that live where they are. You may call them opossum, and you do that because it's the correct term. But I, where I'm from, they're just called possums. And there's a bunch, and again, in all those states I mentioned that I lived in, guess what? There's a bunch of possums. So, I mean, I don't, you know. Again, I don't remember, because I was young when I lived there. I don't remember the specific, like, you know, the fauna of, but it's fairly similar around the Southeast. I mean, there's certain deer variations, but, you know. Speaking of deer, you knew you were going to get whitetail, because that's what we have all over the South. They have blacktail, or do they call them sika up there? I think they call them black. Anyway, we have those deer up in Maryland, which is below the Mason-Dixon line. I don't know if they're here in Virginia. You would think so, with the border there. Not a lot of mule deer, but I think, in fact, I think they're considered an invasive species in a lot of places where they are in the South, but whatever. What else? Oh, the fox. Yeah, I was really hoping for that. And interesting enough, you know, when I was a kid growing up in all these places, like, the fox was like a mysterious animal. Oh, no. Okay, we did it. Oh, still says I'm fading in. All right, do I run back, or do I just fast travel? Let's just fast travel. I really don't think I'm going to find anything else. Honestly, I might come back and find this axis deer, though. Well, I put a tent down, so that scares him just the same way. But as far as deer species, that's pretty much all you're going to find. What else? What do they have on there? What's the predator? Is it bobcats? Probably. Bobcats.
Yeah, that sounds right. Or, you know.
Which is makes sense. And then, but I really wish that, you know, there's coyote all over the south. So is coyote on the map? You know what? Dang it. Oh, come on, pizza. Don't be that guy. Are you that guy again? I'm always that guy. No, I'm not that guy. Fantastic. I got my first cell phone. Pizza's not a young man. My first cell phone I got when I was 32. Which was a while ago. And, and I'm all 1,000% for, let's see, we got alligator. Oh, yeah, we'll talk about that. Raccoon, fox, yeah. Quail. I'm excited about that. Rabbits, turkeys, pigs, and bear. Is that it? More items. Why do I have to read things? You jerks. Blah, 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 blah. Don't you know I'm doing something? Blah, blah, blah. No, they don't care. Blah, blah, blah. Why is there so much garbage? Here we go. Okay. Full list. Alligator, raccoon, fox, gray fox, northern bobwhite quail, bobwhite, eastern cottontail rabbit, wild turkeys, pigs, feral pigs, black bear, and whitetail. So, one, awesome. Another black bear map. I love hunting bears. The pigs, I mean, absolutely makes sense. They're everywhere. Not really in Virginia too much, but the further, the deeper south you go. When you start heading towards the... What do you call places like that? Where it's like... I mean, to me, it's like the southern coast, right? Mississippi and Louisiana, like, I consider that the southern coast. Is it southeast? I mean, it's southern is sort of a state of mind. I mean, Arkansas is southern. Missouri is southern. I mean, I feel like Indiana might tell you they're southern. They got that kind of... I love Indianans. If you haven't met any, you should. They're fun. My mother-in-law from there. Great. Great lady. And she married an Iowan. Which is funny because that's where my parents are from. Or, well, my mom. My dad is from Virginia, born and raised. They're funny. My dad's passed, but so my mom grew up. She'll tell you she grew up on a farm in Iowa, but that's not 100% true. She basically grew up in town, which is funny. I won't tell you the name because you don't need to know the name of the town that my mother grew up in, but it's a small town in Iowa. But they grew up in town, right? Until she was about 12 or 13, and then my grandfather and my grandmother decided to do what a lot of people will do in Iowa, and that's farm. And they bought a farm outside of the small town. But it's kind of interesting. Okay. So they were the big town. That's where they started growing up. And then they moved to the farm outside the little town. My dad, he grew up in, like, the poor side of, well, yeah, you know, let's just be honest. He grew up in the poor side of Richmond. And, I thought I heard something, but no, I'm sorry. Anyway, what was that? He grew up on the poor side of Richmond, and I don't want to go back. Let's start that there. And I'll get up and run down back to this. Oh, no, that's right. It's a different day. Right, did I change time? No, I just fast traveled. Of course I did. My scent is terrible. I'll just wander. Sorry, I'll get to it. I will make it the connection that my parents had. In the summers, he would work on his grandparents' farm in Texas. They had a tobacco farm in Texas, and he grew up in Virginia, in the city. And my mom spent, like I said, until she was about 12, growing up in what they would call the city, and moved to a farm. Corn and soybeans is what they did. My dad didn't want to get drafted during Vietnam. He was a good student, but not the greatest student. And like I said, if you didn't hear me say he grew up on the poorer side of town in Richmond, well, it wasn't like college. Brother got in trouble with the law, which let's not look down on. I mean, people have lives and, you know, stuff happens, right? And the judge said, but what they used to do back then, which is shady as hell, excuse my language, but you know, he was looking at, well, you know, prison time. Couple of years. You made a mistake. And not, you know, yeah. The kind where the judge was like, okay, you can either go into the military or you can serve jail for prison time. Well, you know, what are you going to do? So my uncle, who is, I grew up in the poor side of a city as well, and maybe you don't know these kind of things, but we don't really know how to swim. It's not like a thing. And we have like sometimes like a pool, like at a community center or whatever, but like, anyway, he didn't know how to swim, and he was like scared of the water like the rest of us, and like, you know, they put him in the Navy. But once he got in, it was one of those quick, like, wow, you know, for him anyway, it really, you know, clicked. Where's the edge of this? Oh, I got a ways to go. Anyway, for some people, the military is like, how can I put this? Well, we'll get through the story. So my dad was like, he was 18 in 1969. 6'5", athletic. But not like, you know, college, going to college athlete. You weren't getting enough scholarships or nothing like that. A good student. but not, you know, valedictorian. And so, you know, you're trying to get into college with your application, and what you really need is money, and that was lacking. So 1969, that was prime draft material, right? And from what I understand, you know, it happened to both my mother and my father. You know, he had somebody, a friend, and they got drafted into the Marines and killed, and he didn't want that to happen. Which makes sense, right? I mean, you know, think about the decisions and the lifestyle choices you had to think about back then during that time period, especially when they were drafting people. It was like a lottery, you know? You know, who knows? And my dad loved science fiction and fantasy, and he wanted to be a writer. He wrote, like, I'm pretty sure, my mom says he wanted to be Jack Kerouac, which I could see. But I think he wanted to be more like Ray Bradbury. But anyway, and if he couldn't be Ray Bradbury, he wanted to be a scientist. Because my dad loved one thing, you know, you can always see how the world is impacted by different things, and my dad was impacted by television. You know, he was born in 1951, and so TV was just the stuff. And all those old, like, he's just the right age, you know, to be hit with all those early 60s, mid 60s science fiction, and he wanted to be the scientist. He wanted to be the guy in the lab coat who found the, you know, he figured out the formula and saved the world from the horrible alien invasion. And he knew that the Air Force offered a really good medical program, so he went into that. Did what was required of him. But anyway, so they run into each other in Iowa while he was stationed there training before he went overseas. And you can tell I'm old, because that's what we say. We say overseas. But anyway, so before he went overseas, we got to be getting towards the edge of this. There's not a dang thing here that I can see. At least, let's hope for mule deer, right? And his friend that he made on the base out there was dating a girl who was a friend of my mom's. And he said, well, my buddy's here in Iowa, and I want to go out, find a girl that I'll go out with. My mom, who was like the last person you would expect to go on a blind date. And I was like, sure. And that was that. Done. It was a wrap. They were together till the day he died. Well, they were married. He did have to go to Vietnam. Where he learned to be a medic. And was blown up in a Jeep. He lied to all of us. He told us all that he and his buddy stole a Jeep, and they got in a wreck because they were all drunk. Not true. I don't give the Purple Heart for that one. You got a broken leg. That he would break again in a motorcycle accident. All right. Well, ladies and Jekyllpins, we're going to say no. All right. So let's just, I did kill those axes. Well, let's get back up
here. Yeah, I got back up here.
We're going to see if the muleys are in here. Excuse me. And, rah! Did you hear that? Rah! That's a mule deer, isn't it? Come on, gimme.
Gimme.
Gimme. Mmm. Right, one of them mule deer. Why in the world am I telling? And you know what? Let's look at this bottle. We're about, we're getting, I'd say halfway, but that would be a lie. Yeah. Y'all, I should put me in a soda commercial. Pizza and a bottle of wine. I mean, statistically, the hunting has got to get poorer. But the entertainment value should probably skyrocket. One hour in, people.
All right. We will carefully stalk into the elusive new area on our new map as we discover new zones and new species we have yet to discover. The elusive axis deer has replaced the mule deer. Perhaps pizza is filling the bow shot. A maniacal fool.
Sketchy demon dog, sit down. If anybody's watching, feel free to say hi. I always promise no social commitment. Yeah. No, like, I mean, you can, but, you know, you don't have to share, for Christ's sakes, whatever that is. Or no. Subscribe. I mean, you can. Pizza has one follower.
Pizza Hulk have one follower, y'all.
But, and I'm super proud of that, but they don't really watch my stuff. Or maybe they do. I hope you do. Ooh. I screwed up. Something ran away. Pretty sure that was...
Lordy. We got a half a mile to go.
Oh, no, we don't. We have 350 yards to go. Why is it always a mating call? The last time I chased an axis deer... main call. I got a diamond. And that messes with your brain. You went, no, no calls. No calls. We're on the... No. Axis Theater. 10 o'clock. We'd be on the feed zone. I had to rain man my zones real quick. Sorry. It, 3/4 of a bottle. That's where we're at. because I am itching to get killed by some buffalo, and I think I'm going to change my loadout. Yep. I think I'm going to lose the Solican. Man, do I do that, though? Shoot. I mean, weight-wise, I should go 243. Well, if I was really smart, I'd go with the 223. Right. The 300, the 7mm, and the bow. And I could probably bring the rhino too. That way, if I see a seeker or an axis, I can shoot it with a 223. Man, I don't know if that might be too heavy, though. I gotta go. I'm ADHD, and I don't take medicine because I have to take other kinds of medicine because I am heading towards 50, and I did not take care of myself for a percentage of my lifetime. And Pizza Hulk had a heart attack in May. And also had a little bit of diabetes. So, and by the way, I'm very careful with my diet. I've lost 45 pounds. It's just a lot less junk in this old trunk, but so if you're like, white wine, you know, listen, I'm aware. Precautions have been taken. For lunch today, Pizza had long grain white rice and a steamer pack of mixed veggies with lots of broccoli, both of which contain no salt. And a bunch of spices. Garlic powder, onion powder, crushed red pepper, cayenne pepper, black pepper. You gotta get them peppers in there when you're crazy diet restricted. But I said, everyone's leaving, right? Wine drinking was yesterday, last night. No one's touching this bottle because it's, well, it's garbage. But its alcohol content is not bad. Man, there's nothing out here. Is this really? A one zone lake. Again, I guess you know what? I'm just gonna have to do another video at some point where I go looking for these guys at night. Where's the edge? Yeah, really not far on this side. Yeah. In fact, I'm just gonna sneak out through the shoreline. I mean, honestly.
Yeah.
We'll just run it out. You gotta love brothers. Well, you gotta. Anyway, my brother, I love my brother. He's heading out. Good for the old love you text. He's not a 30-minute goodbye kind of guy. And my family's not really a 30-minute kind of goodbye family. I mean, some of them. No.
Later. Love ya.
This is crap. So, I mean, okay, this map is flummoxing. I have quandaries. It's a bit of an enigma. You should always try to use big words when you're drinking. Wow. Well, okay. Well, seems like an opportunity missed. So, I'm curious how alligators are going to work in Mississippi. It'll probably be weird. It'll probably be broken. But hopefully in the long run, you know, it's like a lot of games they release now. We'll get there. I'm really excited about the raccoon. I feel like there's a missed opportunity by adding with the raccoon and the fox, that's dope. And the pig, too, you know, alright. But I feel like something else, you know, like we could have had a possum. And yes, I said a possum. I'm doing it for my northern friends. But, yeah. And squirrel. And where are the ducks? They gotta be coming. And I want two. Two types. You get it together. If you're gonna... How do you exclude ducks? Anyway. Black bear, stupid excited. White-tailed deer. I think this needs to be another place you can hunt the great one. Because if you're going to find a great one, I feel like the Southeast is definitely one of those places. So. Quail's cool. I don't know. Probably won't like it much because I don't really like the pheasant hunting. Why? I'm like a 22 guy. I like hunting... turkey with shotguns in Colorado. But everywhere else, I prefer the 22. Even on Rancho, where you can get kind of close. It's just, I'm excited about a new 22. That I believe is going to shoot level 2 animals, which completely makes sense to me and irritates the hell out of me that I can't shoot level 2s with the 22 that I have, because a 22 would absolutely kill a coyote or a lynx or whatever. Definitely a fox. So... Honestly, I just feel like it's a correction that should have been a feature on the first 22. Yeah. Alright, there's nothing here. Oh, come on. I don't know if I even care. about this other lake. But when I first started playing this game and I figured out how much I had screwed up and didn't use my weapon packs that I had and all this stuff, anyway. You know, I just thought, man, that 22 should 100% kill a coyote or a fox. And kill you. 22 pistol is a dangerous weapon. As is a 22 rifle. It should be treated just like it's not a BB gun. You know. I don't know. I think, like I said, it's more of a correction of what should have happened with the first 22 rifle. So, and it keeps you from having to take the 243 on a map where you have to shoot twos. Which just adds extra weight. It makes you make choices like, I can't bring the boat with me, which I hate. Well, you know, I brought the tent here, so I'm gonna go left, but, I mean, it was a good access to your zone, just, you know, there was nothing else. I mean, again, I wonder if anything else is rendering. I don't know about you guys, but I've been having trouble with the rendering with my animals coming in. When I fast travel, when I change the time, whatever. Oh, I healed though. Man, I'm really excited. Like, I'm looking forward to getting to the other side of the map and start looking for these, So, because of the glitch and I haven't explored much, and you can see this river is just ripe. From what I understand, especially through this area, I think, a lot of Cape Buffalo, so, or water buffalo, there we go. So, I'm excited about that. That's what I really want to do. And I haven't even going here yet. So. My brain is somewhere else. I'm thinking about doing something else already before I get to this lake, which is still 500 yards away. And I doubt there are any water buffalo. Or maybe any animals at all. I might just bail. What time is it? So, if I don't see any of the early morning animals, no reason I can't leave the tent here. Check the, the zone later for the later animals. 9:30 and I'm on the lawn. I can switch to the 7mm. Nah. I could go 300 and... see, so that would be 300, 223. 303, the bow. And the rhino, can I do that? Maybe. I don't think any other 4 to 8 is lighter than the 303. They all weigh the same. I mean, when you're buffalo hunting, you can, the crossbow will do, it, you can, I guess, sort of use it like a pistol, but like a single action revolver, like a, you gotta load. Not even a revolver, really. Like a revolver that you have to reload like a single action rifle. It's making me think of like more like a 308, right? Pistol in, what's that game, in Fallout. .123, y'all. If you just joined us, welcome. Not much going on. If you stuck it out, you're a beast and a champion. Welcome to Pizza in a Bottle of Wine. We were talking about the new map. I tell you one thing I'm excited about is the swamp look to it and climbing through all those. Looks like they're going to put those weird little board bridges that are in Layton. I'm not a big fan of those, but whatever. I want to know how, like, can I get on the water too? I want to know if it's shallow enough for me to, like, just wander through. Because if you lived anywhere where there's a swamp, well, you're going to get your muck boots on and your Carhartts or your rubber duckies in your suit and wander out in all that muck and water. So, I mean, yeehaw to the bridge and everything. Oh, man. Is this one of those weird as heck dry river beds? I think it is. So these are on multiple maps. I don't know if they're supposed to be that way, because sometimes we're going to do some science here in a minute, because it's pizza and a bottle of wine. You can hear splashing, and look how deep it is. On these weird dry riverbeds, I don't recall catching any animals ever. So, you know what would be funny though? Is that flashing? No. A duck zone with some ducks on it, just kind of floating above one of those. Anyway, like I said, I think this is supposed to have water in it. Hear it? I bet if I go far enough, it'll kick me back to the shore, you think? I don't hear any splashing. So, the question Pizza had was, do I leave the tent or not? Dang it. Let's go get this dang tent. Yeah. I think I'm gonna go up here. Goes bit early, huh? Something wrong. Alright, these crazy boys and girls are on the drink. When? 10. I mean, I prefer to start at 10:30. Let's see. I mean, there's a hunting stand, so. Well, invest in the pack mule perk, because it is just a game changer. Alright, well, God, how do I even do this setup? It's ridiculous. Okay. Ooh, I don't know if I can get the scope, though. Oh, it's already on. Nah, again, yay. They got the bullets. No. Blah, 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 blah. What did I grab? Something. 223 polymer tip. Definitely. 100%. Grab a couple more of. Should I do, or should I go 44? Well, it's 4 to 9. Super exciting, isn't this? Let's see. So, a bit of a ridiculous setup for me. Restroom. So, bathroom break for everyone. Right? Remember that in school? Even if you didn't have to go, it was nice for a minute. So, we're going to do that. I'm out of caffeine. All right. Five. Take five. Greetings and salivations. I've been busy eating turkey and cranberries and a little apple pie with some ice cream. If you're here, ooh-wee. You're a tough person. Feel free to say hi. No social obligation after that. But I'd be best. Let's see. Beefalo hunting, right? Well. Theory. Zone hunting, anyway. I don't have a diamond water buffalo. If I read it right, then this area, this river area, which looks also, water buffalo. We're going to see if they're in here. That is the plan. YouTuber, I like to watch for a YouTuber I like to watch that has good hot zones. Recommended this area for water buffalo. Well, the river, just period. And I looked at a couple other videos and pretty much the same thing. The zones are gonna vary. Now, if you stuck it out, if you just managed to tune in, or you pulled up and you're like, what is happening? Why is this camera just sitting here? There's nothing going on. Well, I needed something to eat, and I didn't feel like turning the video off. Yeah, this looks like water buffalo country, right? I mean, come on. Can you get across the river? You wouldn't think so. That's too wide. Oh, look. There's a line. There's a line right there, huh? All right, well, it goes. So, anyway. I got some turkey and some cranberries. sweet potato, corn pudding. What else? Rolls were gone. Basically, I'm just picking through what's left of the leftovers. Not much. A little bit of stuffing.
Stuffing? You mean dressing?
Nah. The bird gets stuffed in this house. It's not a brag. It's kind of dangerous, actually, but if you trust the person doing it, it's pretty good. Who does it in your family? My mom. So, we trust her. Hasn't killed us yet. Yeah. Anyway, I don't really know how to hunt this area. Truthfully. We just know there's supposed to be... Well, now, honestly, I think it's really supposed to be more like down this way. But I wanted to see what was up here. My thinking was, oh, there's a hunting stand here. Maybe there's something around here. Maybe mule deer. But, no, this is mule deer time, too. They come on at, like, 9:30. 9:30. I should probably be closer to the water. But there's this weird little inlet. Who knows if my wind is good. Depends on where the animals are. Right? What map has those annoying bugs? Is it New Zealand? Rancher? Anyway. Pizza and a bottle of wine, had a, 30-minute break? Jesus, who knows. I didn't think my son was still here, but he was. So we had a little... later evening turkey bash snack. I'm assuming it's a $1,700 stand, which usually are crap. Oh no, this is one of the bigger. No, it's $1,700. Now you can get experience from that too, and I will tell you that, you know, depending if you're out here at the right time. These stands can be pretty potent ways to get a bunch of kills, but you know, I don't know. I know very little about this map. Except that I believe you're supposed to look for B-flow along the river. And that's what I'm gonna do. And since they run sort of concurrent with the mule deer, hopefully maybe we'll spot some of those, because I'd really like to find those too. Well, I'm just going to say right out, the best animal, I mean technically I guess, in the game that I've shot so far is a diamond albino mule deer. So, pretty neat. I got a pobble too. Sort of walk. It just feels empty. There's a shoreline. Anyway, I don't know. I got a hot zone map. A couple. And listen to me, just because I mentioned someone, I'm endorsing them, maybe, I guess, in a way, but they don't know me. Okay, so let's not get too stupid. But, Lady Legend has some pretty good hot zone maps. And I'll tell you why. Because well, I think she understands that, like, you're not looking for exact zones. You're looking for areas. Because your map's going to be different than hers or mine or anybody else's. So there's a lot of goofy information out there. Maps on Reddit and whatever that are like, oh, they're fine. Here's all the zones in Clayton Lakes. Well, it's almost impossible. There's nothing out here. But I kind of wondered. I mean, maybe it's Red Deer or something. I don't know. And I mean, you know, obviously I could be scared. So I wonder if this is what Mississippi looks like. At least some of it. It definitely could be. Thought I heard something. Who knows? I don't know the noises on this map. So far, this isn't going so well. Fantastic. What do I got to, like, 1:30 or something? I don't even know if it goes that late. No, you'd think so. Here, maybe? Like here or something? 10:30 to 1:30. Ugh. No tracks. Nothing. Yeah, you know, when you do get on these maps, remember there's big swaths of areas where there's not necessarily anything. Because you see this big chunk of water, I mean, mule deer should be on, and maybe black buck in their feed zones. Well, we got about 4 more swallows and we finish the bottle of wine. But pizza's old and pizza knows that you don't drink and not eat and take care of your body at the same time, so we had a snack break. Man, this just looks like another garbage stand. I don't understand what's supposed to be out here. And when? Is this like the Red Deer Coast? Ugh. Right, so, alright, so I got all this, you know, stands and crap through here, but I'm like an hour into the Cape or the Water Buffalo Zone and I'm not hearing anything, seeing anything, you know. Like I said, it's a shared time. I believe most of the water buffalo actually run down this way, so we'll run up to this one, and if we don't see anything, we'll change time. But yeah, I'm hoping Mississippi is like, you know, kind of like this, shallow, I can get through. It'd be nice to have some animals. I mean, I don't know if I'm scared anything up further, because one of the things when you, it's like latent, I guess, where I guess your water zone could really actually be way further up here, you know what I mean? Doesn't necessarily have to be on the, look at all this, you know what I'm saying? So, I mean, nothing's running away. I don't know. See this. The hunting has been really good, and I've been hitting the water pretty much just solely. And so on the lakes, it's going pretty well, but you know, I recall hunting this place before and thinking there were some spots that just didn't seem like the best place to hunt. Yeah, this is looking rough. I mean, I'm not saying there's not stuff in here. I don't think it's water buffalo time or mule deer time. No warnings, no tracks, nothing. Not even leftover zones from before, but why have all this stuff out here? I mean, look at all these things, you know, like, I'm assuming that's another hunting stand. I don't know. And the thing is, you know, it depends on what you want, because, I mean, I look at maps too. Other zone maps that do have specific zones listed on them, and that doesn't hurt either, because at least it gives you an idea. So I would say with Lady Legend, you're definitely getting a good idea of where certain animals are in a generalized area, but you might want to look at somebody's actual map with zones on them. And she does that too. But I don't know what they're talking about. They're like, oh, run down the coast. This is where all the water buffalo are. Water buffalo and mule deer are on at the same time, so maybe I thought I'd find something, but there's nothing. You know what I'm saying? Like nothing. But like all this stuff. I'm done. As a matter of fact, we're gonna go over here, change the time, and go down the opposite coast. I guess I gotta go back there in the morning, or again, maybe this is a nighttime hunting map. I don't know. Not my favorite kind of map. I'd like to be more than 300 yards, but whatever. We'll see if there's any stuff in here. Maybe flows on the other. That's it. Well, I thought I heard something off to the right, but I'm not 100% sure. I was also eating a piece of red licorice, and I didn't want to eat a piece of red licorice in here. So, hunting beefalo is like hunting any. No, it's not. It's like hunting an apex predator. But there's that point where you just kind of got to go, it's a video game, and I'm just going to have to either die or not. So we got two zones there. We got a feed zone, 5 to 10:30, which is going off, and then hopefully a drink zone. Yeah, 20. 10:30 to 1:30. So where are they? I mean, my wind's not bad. I think it's cool. I got two zones right on top of each other, which is kind of what you hope for. I'm assuming they're up there, like the other side of the zone, but you know, I've been having render problems. What? Y'all see that big seven right there, right? Coming. Might just shoot him. The thing about hunting these guys is that you don't really know what you have. Look at the herd. I'm glad Big Boy came running out, but he's dead. But I mean, picking him up is going to be tricky. Looks like an orange. Sorry, I decided to start snacking right when things got interesting. Right here is a bunch of females, but I mean, I killed that male. So, when I come in on a bunch of dangerous animals like this, you gotta make a choice of, like, you know, that's a 4 female. Do you shoot something else? Do you shoot just because think there's a male and I should shoot a male. Oh, dang it. Let's see if I can get him through these bushes, but we're getting into seriously dangerous territory. I guess that's my point. You kind of be. Uh oh. You're kind of a little loose. Because. You kind of have to be, you know? You got to get these guys out of here. If. You want to pick up your prize, so. Let's see. I like to get in quick and try to use a dog. And just get what, I mean, you know, as soon as possible, get what you can. I want to say that other one was probably more like here. Looks like good blood, though. You know, they're hard to hunt. Especially when you actually, the more they are, the harder they can be to hunt. Oh, he's tracking the other one. Alright, well, let's, yeah, I know, bro. Let's take care of this one real quick. That's a big old feller. Let's throw you in there. Oh, it is an orange. 36. No, a dark red. Alright. I just got a trophy. And a mission. Harvest a water buffalo down by a single shot. Okay, buddy. I'm coming. Let's go. Anyway, so yeah, I mean, I approach this like I'd hunt lions. I mean, this is some dangerous stuff. And trying to be quiet right now, it might not be the best decision, but I mean, at least keeps me from attacking me too. Here they come. So that's an 8. Get the right gun, Pizza. Get the right gun. Oh, we gonna shoot this fella right here. Let me tell you what. What's this? Many bigs. Where are you? No, come on. Lost it. No, come on. All right, you need to sit down. Shut it. Ah, they're scaring. Dang it. I don't know which one had that mythical. Is that that looks like it back behind that tree? That's just a big old. God dang it! I'm trying to get over here. Should I just shoot it? I should just shoot it. This one right here. I'm just gonna shoot it. Look for the copper. All right. Yeah, that's him. That's 100% him. How is a tree in the way every single moment? It's stupid. I cannot believe there's still another tree. Yeah, we're gonna do this. Alright, if I'm getting a second shot, I want it with the pistol. I don't think so, though. There's another orange. Woo! That's what I mean, though. And this female might be coming in on me. Oh! She is. We hit her. Don't do that. Look! Get him, dog! Get her! Get her! Yeah, die, will you? Oh, that smoked her. do this. Round. We finished another mission. Yield your backup. Gunslinger. Good lord. Whatever. We gotta get out of here, man. Come on, dog. We gotta man. I mean, is that still a buffalo zone? Sure is. Alright, well, anything else, we probably screwed up, but that's fine. It was real close. I mean, I remember seeing it down. Yeah, there we go. There we go. Anyway, that's why it's going to be difficult to get zones, even. Sure. Sure. Alright, where's that other one? There we go. That's vital blood. That's vital blood. Alright. There it is. Perfection. Perfection. Is it saying that I'm on a different water zone? Man, I wonder if I click it will lose it. Shoot. 7. Alright, let's get this mythical. I'll probably just trophy it out. It'll be faster. God, that's huge. Taxidermized, yes, yes. Because there's more in here I can hear. If I can pick up this zone, I think it's on the edge. I'm real nervous. No, I should be alright. I should be alright. I think I'm gonna get 2 buffalo zones. Man, oh man, you guys. What a bunch of fun that was, huh? Let's see if we can get another one. Mythical. Please. Oh, that's dang pumas. Somebody's coming in. I can kill a puma or a buffalo. Yeah, you should be scared, bro. I want to get a little further in and see if I can get some buffalo tracks. Here we go. We're going to cover that puma zone. 18. I know. Ain't no joke, friend. Oh, a male. Ooh. 6. What are you? Something else. It don't really matter. How about we shoot this 6? What do you think, guys? Run! What kind of running is that? I might lose this. This is a brand new zone. I might lose it. Nope. I did it! Boom! Alright. That's what I thought. I knew there was one in here. I could hear it. You coming for me or what? What are you? Go on, get out of here. Oh. Could just have blown them zones right there. We'll see. Is he dead? Yeah, I just blew that zone. Oh well. That's kind of what happens though. I'm a little sad. Oh, no, I see it. Never mind. Come here. That also means, like when you're goose hunting, gloves are off. You know, I thought about it too. I was like, I don't have to shoot this. Now the zone is gone, but it's questionable whether they'll come back, because sometimes they do. Even when the zone's gone, they'll keep coming back, because or like maybe to the new zone. Oh no, we got some good kills and some good money. I got one of these in one zone. And this zone will come back. Heart. I love shooting these things, a black water buffalo. So is that, does they have melanistic? I don't know. But no lie. It said come down this coast. I'm a mythical in and a blown out zone. And fun, man. These guys are fun. They'll kill you too. So we'll see. All right, let's get up. Yeah. I was like, is that them? Like I said, it's kind of a free-for-all, but it might lead into another zone. So free-for-all canceled. Sorry, guys. We should be... Go get it. Oh, no. Oh no! Where are you? Why are you up here? Searching. It shouldn't be that difficult, bruh. I wonder how far I went. Is that it? No. Okay. Good, let's go. Alright. That's the one that killed the zone, though. So, we blame the buffalo. And don't forget it. I was about to say, so I know they're in here and my scent is on them. Although he called from a weird, you know, much further up. And I will say this, I mean, that you can mimic any sound. I could literally record the sound of buffalo and play it. So we don't have a caller. I know, dude. What I really want is your zone. Oh, there they are. Oh, see, they're friggin' alarmed. I guess I gotta wait. We'll go left. What do we think? Any big males left? I wouldn't even know how to spot them. It just says they're traveling. Like, how are they traveling? Show me somebody drinking or eating or something. Come on. There's a six. Defensive. I don't know. Let's see. We got an hour and some change on the zone. Wow, yeah, we have nuked some water beef left. Okay, you still defensive? You look defensive to me. They don't know I'm here. Specifically. There's a 7. Like, I wouldn't... I could probably shoot him. Okay. 60. Is that... That can't be right. I kind of want to bow shot him. You don't want to try to bow shot 7 very hard. Buffalo. Of course we do, pizza. Anything stupid with your life. I'm sure. That makes sense. Why? Well, I'd say the same. Alright. Let's see if we can get this 7.
No, you're a joke.
No one wants you 4. Just accept it and give it up. You know what? I think it's just the guy in front of me. Right? Oh, this is so dumb. I missed. Pistol Tom. I said Pistol Tom. Well, I want the zone. So we're going in. There it is. And I'm going to do something I rarely do. But 100% recommend it in this particular situation. Going in with a gun in my hand. What do you range that? 55? That's fine. Ooh. What are they still doing, by the way? Defensive. I mean, do we see a male? I saw a 5 female earlier. I'd love to shoot her. Oh, right back there. See how wiggly head? That's probably a male. One in them. We got 2 in them. And now you start to see the issue with hunting animals like this, because look at the pressure. I mean, I think I can get this zone. I gotta get out of here, though. I guess I'll pick him up first. Well, and I gotta remember I can bow hunt these guys. You know? Yeah, another gold. See a zone? We do. Alright. Yeah, they're coming back in. I think I cherry picked the best so far. Let's get a win. 13. Alright. I don't know. There's a 6. How far outside of this pressure is it? Right on the edge. I could probably get him. There's another one. 135, 151. Another zone? Nope. I agree. Bow shots only from here on out. So, we got that. Alright. This is fun. I'm really glad this map is working. We got a feed zone now too. I do your thing though. We should be careful. Okay, let's throw in the feed zone on top of it. I mean, I'm looking at losing a lot if I mess this up. Yeah, 20. Oof. I mean, look, it's everything's so connected. They gotta be moving in real soon. I guess that's the biggest problem for me. Picking up your kills. Shut it. I'm coming. God. Whoa. It's cool. It's all cool. Right. Does that say a 5 female? Holy cow. There's another orange. These are some big ladies. I don't know if I can get by them without shooting somebody. I mean, if I'm going to shoot somebody, I want to shoot that one. If I can stay out here in the shallows, I will. Just try to keep it to a male. There's two of them. That's my bull. I got the right ammo, right? Shoot. Let's get down there. Get a range. I'm just gonna get behind that other female. Never mind. We might end up with a female. Alright, I'm gonna try to get side on him, or broadside on him. What a mess. This could kill the zone, but I don't just want to get him. I got this cam sticking my way. Well, pizza does the work. Pizza does the work. Don't let it be not said. Woo wee. I mean, I'm assuming another gold. I don't know which one was better. Huh. Alright. Let's hurry. I got good blood. Please be the one. Sit. Alright. I would like... Ooh. We got an hour. Did I kill another zone? Did I kill one I didn't find? I don't remember if I... Oh, there's two out here. Oh, jeez. I think I killed another zone. How many zones do I have? Water. Just two. And then we definitely killed this one. Oh. Keep going. Gold. On a six. So, badass six, right? I mean... I know. I'm so sorry. I wouldn't even know. I'd be. There's just no way. It'd have to be a bow shot. And even then, I shouldn't. Nope. I should get out of here and run very far away. I start looking some more. Are you warning coming back in, or are you warning on a different zone? That would be the question. I'm going to keep pushing forward till I die, or... We run out of the zone time, which isn't too much longer. All Or get a shot on an animal. Outside of the zone. Don't think that's gonna happen. But, I mean, I don't think you can technically lose a zone you haven't gotten yet. There's another seven. Where are we on? Oh, we're good. He's gonna go on that inside track right there. Well, I know where he is. Oh, shoot. I knew where he was. Oh, okay, well. Get low. Oh, get up. No. They're running. That's alright. Run, brown, orange cow. I might take advantage of this. Yeah, let's go. I'm going to leave that 7 and not even worry about it because I want to get out of all of this pressure. And that was a bit, those were big herds. So, and it's maybe split zones. So, I'm gonna. We got about a half an hour. So, let's shoot for here. I know they're in here. Our brown one didn't go very far, I don't think. I know. Grumpy. But I didn't really get attacked too much, so that's good. Let's run a little bit. Okay, alright, well, wow. I know I blew out one. I don't know how the zone thing works when you blow out an area that doesn't have a zone that you clicked on yet. I know sometimes it'll pop up, you click on it, and it immediately goes away. I'm definitely not disappointed. Well, we got some big ones. We got a mythical, right? Yeah. It is certainly exciting, and like I said, I'm sorry I missed it, but you know, it's just making me think about Africa. Hunting them Cape Buffalo. I know those warthogs are mean too. Lions. About how far did we get in? Oh, nothing. Nothing. Nothing at all, really. Yeah. Because I believe they're all up and down this coast. We'll see. With the next outpost be? Oh, yeah. Alright, so I'll push through here. I'll get up. Oh, I hit on something. Well, if it's the only one on there, I don't necessarily want to shoot. Oh, we got some ducks too. I understand. If I see more than one, I wouldn't worry about it. But I only really saw that one. Oh, you're calm now, but wait till I come running here like a crazy person. Oh no. What if you got out of... There it is. So we now know she's not allowed. Thanks for pushing me. Well, I scared him out. Which would be the best course? Let's go. The sound is screwing up. So dangerous hunting, right? It'd be nice if this was an elevated stand, but I'm gonna be saying probably not. I feel like some of these maps are just mean with their stands, you know? Like, unnecessarily. Is that a feed zone? Looks like it. Looks like I'm getting that one too. Well, I am really looking forward to hunting this map from now on. I think we're going to have some different kind of hunts going on. One. We'll see. Busy little area. Looks like a good place to hunt ducks, doesn't it? So, we're almost done with this time zone. I was hoping this was elevated. Like, prove me wrong kind of thing. Holy shnikes. Oh, it's an orange. Do it. Get the right arrows in here. Oh. Oh. tired of this game. Vertebrae, pelvis. Yeah, we finally got him. An orange, though. What is with the crap stand out here? Why not give me... Why not give me the full stand? We'll run a little further. That's about halfway. Here. Just gonna see if there's any leftover zones. I mean, the trick with this is that the feed zones and the drink zones are basically right on top of each other, so. That looks like a drink zone, though. Yep. This is one. Okay, sure. Just walking back into that other zone. Well, you know, you can always tell when pizza's getting tired because the commentary trails off. But, yeah, there we go. Probably just blew the one shot I had. Nope, there it is. I was like, who else is yelling at me? Me too. Well, we got the zone at least. The four is on the run. Weird. So they're basically like resting, drinking, and like eating all around the same time. Cause that's not a rest sound marker, that's a drink sound marker. Dang. is happening? A mule deer. Is that a boyfriend? Yeah, this is the wrong area for you. What are you doing? Scare this deer up. Don't hit me. Look at this. Now I want to point out there was definitely two buffalo on that drink sign, and it says just one. I'm gonna push on to that marker. And then call it good. Cause we're off the drink soon. And I'm tired. But I'm gonna say good session. We got one zone for sure, maybe a potential other zone. But I didn't find it either, so. I don't think I actually blew that zone. So if I just go out and shoot the pressure off of doing something else, it'll be fine. So water buffalo will become orange, I guess. And what, the capes are brown? I don't know. I don't know enough about these species because I haven't been able to hunt here. So. Feels like yeah, there we go. When the buffalo are done, when they're done, but the zones they move into, it must be real close. So one more zone. I mean, it says one, but I'm not buying that. Oh. Hmm. It's near. What are you doing? What are you guys doing? Are you moving in? Yeah, yell at that stupid dog. I'm just gonna fast travel. Yeah. It's just a female. Yeah. That's enough excitement for one day. So, not disappointed at all. Buffalo hunting is difficult. Any, like, really dangerous big game hunting is difficult. So. I don't know. I'm gonna come back one more time. And I'm gonna work this coast. So, we'll start here, come back out here. Go to here. Jump over to this one, switch the time back, and come down through here. Get this outpost. Yeah. And that'll be the deal for tomorrow. Let's get off the ground, guys. But, like I said, as far as flushing out the map is concerned, we're doing pretty good. I think I was too early on this area, or too late, maybe. That's what it was. I'm betting there's a bunch of red deer in there. Read that there was a bunch of buffalo through here. So far, so good. I might have already found some. What do we got here? Mule deer? Nah. Yeah, buffalo. See? So, we'll keep the trend and push through there and all around this coastline for water buffalo on our next adventure. And then, I think Africa, because I want to see if at least, that was where my other lag problem was. So, I want to see if that's cured and fixed or redeemed. And if so, we'll start looking for some zones. I haven't even finished the main storyline there. I just got mad and it was like, I have another parque, Here's another parque where I can't hunt, but for like 45 minutes. But I'm also curious because, a lot of tracks and a lot of animals, so there'll be some lagging anyway. But I'm real hopeful. I'm real excited. So, good things that have happened. I got a diamond red deer. I got a diamond axis deer today. Earlier. I've found some zones. Really, really, it's about zones. Right. The funny thing is, this is a nice red deer zone, or axis deer zone, but that's it. Oh, there was another lake. This thing didn't have anything on it, but I killed this lake. I was good hunting on both these right here. And there's red deer under this puma. And this axis. And, yeah. So, at least around the water, we're filling in the map. Feed zones, but I think I'm gonna get a fair amount at least to go with these water buffalo because they eat from 5 to 10:30 and they drink from 10 to 13:30. So, you know, yeah. Looks good, looks good. Looks like the Water Buffalo Coast is going to be just exactly that. And, you know, we'll work on our zones another day, because I'm going to Africa after this. It kind of looks like this. And I'm going to get some lions and some... What's on that map? Jackals, lions, wildebeest. I do have a gold medal. No. I have a gold medal, gold, blue wildebeest. I love saying that. What else? Kudu. Ah, jeez, I don't even know. Rabbits. So, I'm looking forward to that. And then, eventually, we'll take some of this money. If I quit buying new trophies. Where are we out in the cash grind? Kind of goes up and down. 229. Yeah, we went down. But, we'll finish setting up for the Great One Red Deer grind. Maybe actually do some grinding. But, wow. I almost want to just goof around for 7 more minutes for a 4-hour video, but that seems ridiculous. So, if you somehow caught this evening pizza and a bottle of wine, well, the bottle of wine is gone, and soon pizza is about to be gone too. And all praise to you for sticking it out. Like I said, if you manage to do that, you are a beast. And should be recognized as one. So, all hail. And, yeah, I'm good. I'm real good. I like shooting them as buffaloes go. So, I'm looking forward to doing more of that. Alright, guys. Hope you're doing well. Continue doing so, and as I always say,